panicking Democrats now say Donna Brazile's a Russian puppet, they're desperate. To Democrats these days, everything is a Russian scheme. Trump winning the White House? Russia. The Hillary Clinton email hack? Russia. The leaky faucet in your kitchen? That's Russia's fault, too, and there are probably Putin operatives hiding in your bushes. Democrats are so stuck on the Russian conspiracy narrative that they're now applying it to prominent figures in their own party. The most recent target of the Blame Russia crowd is none other than Donna Brazile, a one-time campaign manager for Al Gore's 2000 presidential run, veteran Democrat operative and former chairwoman of the Democratic National Committee. Brazile's bombshell report of how Hillary Clinton used shady strong-arm tactics to control the DNC in the Democrat primaries and wrestle the nomination away from Bernie Sanders has exploded in the press, and Clinton's die-hard allies are already throwing their former friend under the bus. In an open letter published by the website Medium, the usual suspects of Hillary loyalists attacked Brazile and claimed that she was spreading propaganda from the former Soviet nation. Hillary Clinton gets called out for being Al Capone in a pantsuit. Russia's fault. It is particularly troubling and puzzling that she would seemingly buy into false Russian-fueled propaganda, spread by both the Russians and our opponent, about our candidate's health, the hand-wringing letter declared. It was signed by Huma Abedin, John Podesta, Robbie Mook, and Jennifer Palmieri. Clinton's inner circle. The line about our candidate's health is a reference to Brazile's assertion that she considered replacing Clinton with Joe Biden on the DNC ticket after Clinton's much-publicized collapse after a 9/11 memorial ceremony in New York on September 11, 2016. The general election loss was devastating for us all and something we live with every day. And while frustrating that the general election vote total did not change the outcome of the election, we remain proud that Hillary Clinton and Tim Kaine received nearly 3 million more votes in the general election than their opponents, the open letter also said. Newsflash, the presidential election is based on electoral college votes, guys. Fixating on the popular vote a year after the election is like a losing football team bragging that they had more rushing yards, it's irrelevant and smacks of desperation. It also smacks of a losing future. The Sanders supporters now know beyond a shadow of a doubt that the Democrat Party swindled them out of a real chance at the nomination, then used the septuagenarian socialists to try to appeal to enough young white voters to swing the election Hillary's way. But the adults in the party know that Antifa terrorism and Black Lives Matter tantrums aren't going to win the white middle-class votes that delivered the Midwest, and the election, to Donald Trump in 2016. Like a family fight at Thanksgiving dinner, the entire Democrat Party seems to be devolving into chaos and backstabbing at the very time it needs to come together. Whether the excuse du jour is Russia, email security, chauvinism, or pointy-head invisible aliens for that matter, the result is the same. Democrats lost big a year ago, and until they stop squabbling and living in denial, they're going to have an uphill battle at the ballot box. Let's hope they keep squabbling.